security access in UDS protocol. That is algorithm for security access. That's what we are going to see in this video tutorial. Please visit our site www.eduserve.company for more information. Alright, so this is our channel Learn Automotive. That is, you can come to know about the OBD protocol that we are making. So soon it will be published altogether. And before that, we are giving some explanation on how to deal with the hydraulic component with the ECU, how the communication happens, how the sensors send a request and actuator or respond to that using ECU. That's what the agenda of this channel is. If you want to follow, you can subscribe to this. The link has been given in the description. All right, so let's quickly go into the tutorial. Security access algorithm in UDS. Yes, this security access service ID is 0x27, and this is a client side, this is the ECU side. You can tell client as a tester and ECU as a server. All right, so first step is sending a request. That is, tester is sending the request for the seed to the ECU. ECU will just generate the seed, and for the respective key also will be generated, but ECU will only transmit the seed to the tester. So the tester has to derive or calculate the same key that he have to send to the ECU again. Once ECU validate whether the respective key is correct or not. If it is correct, it will give you the positive response. If not, it will give the negative security access. We'll start with the positive response, right? So as here we know, the tester is initiating the communication, and we'll jump to the fourth step. In the fourth step, the tester is giving the valid data to the ECU. The ECU is processing and it just evaluating the key value. Once it is perfectly matching, so it will give the positive response to access the data. Then the for some time, that is like 30 seconds or 1 minute or 2 minutes, the tester can able to access the data. That depends on the OEM to OEM. That also we'll see in the upcoming video tutorials. All right, so this is for the positive response. If it is negative response, how it will be? All right, so this is here again in the fourth step. From the first step we can see, because the first three step has been discussed here, while calculating or while deriving, there is some mistake or some unauthorized person as trying to access the ECU data. So is giving the wrong key value, and in this step the ECU will evaluate the key value and it finds there is mismatch with the value. So it is giving the negative response code, that is NRC. After receiving the NRC, the sequence has to be abort, or the tester has to start the new sequence. So this is what the algorithm flow for the negative response code. But here I have not mentioned the negative response code. All right, so the question for you is, here we have two questions for you. Tester can request for wrong key for maximum 2 times as per the assumption requirement. Yeah, this is one NRC actually. Say for example, in some project there will be the threshold even 1 time or 3 times or 5 times or even 2 times. So in this requirement, I'm just giving the assumption requirement. Here the tester can request with the wrong key for maximum 2 times. All right, so if it exceeds, then ECU will respond with the NRC. So what the question is, what is that NRC is if it exceeds number of attempts? Please leave a comment. And second question is, when the tester requesting with the wrong key value, then what will be the NRC code is? So this is the wrong key, this is the exceeds the number of attempts. All right, so please leave your comment in the comment section. And yes, as you know, let's have a Google Meet on UDS service on 5/9, that is 8 p.m. Indian Standard Time, with this link. The link has been given in the description. All right, so if you're not subscribed, subscribe to this channel, as well as you can just have a look on this channel. If it finds useful, can follow. Catch you in the next video with another interesting stuff. Bye, until then, take care.